In this Traction 7 tutorial, we're looking at how to bounce tracks and how to render audio. Welcome to Simple Green Tech, where we do tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you create great digital content. I'm Radio Zane, and if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing as we do weekly videos focusing on audio for music, video, streaming. Basically, if it's audio, we try to cover it. In today's video, we're doing a Traction T7 tutorial showing you how to bounce tracks and how to render audio. If you're new to Traction T7, I put a link to Traction's website in the description below so you can head over and grab a free copy of T7 for yourself. I've also included a link to our Traction T7 tutorial playlist in case you want to check out more videos like this one. But now let's get started. First off, we're going to start with a piece of audio that we recorded. Now let's say we just want to slice this up a bit for editing purposes. So let's create some slices and rearrange the audio a bit. Okay, now we have everything edited and lined up the way we want it. And maybe this is a section you want to reuse later on in your project. And it would be kind of annoying to have to copy and paste all of these little clips and make sure you get them right later on in the project. It would be much easier to just have one file. So what we want to do is bounce the audio to another track. To do this, let's go to an open track, right-click over here, and go down to audio tracks. Then select the track name or the track number that you would like to bounce into this track. Now we want to arm this track for recording by clicking the red button here, and we want to click where we want the cursor to start playing from. When you're ready to go, you can hit the record button below. Then once you've bounced the section that you want, you can stop the recording. And you now have a single bounced track that you can easily move around your timeline. Traction also gives us another easy way to do this with their built-in render option. First, let's mark the region that we want to render to a new track by dragging these blue markers over to the start and to the finish. Then we click over here on the track so it's not clicked on just a clip within the track. Go down to the bottom and click Render. You now have some options here. You can choose if you want it to be in stereo or mono. You can also change the sample rate and size. Typically, I choose whatever the original file is. You also want to make sure that you have only render marked region selected, so it just renders everything between your markers. If you have any plugins on the track and you'd like to render the audio the way it sounds through the plugins, then select this option here. But if you plan on just dragging this clip back up into that track, then you shouldn't render it with the plugins, as you're going to double up on them when you bring it back into the track. You can also see up here where it's going to save this new rendered track on your hard drive. You can change that location if you like, or just leave it as it is, and it's going to go right into your project folder. Once you're ready, click Render, and your new clip will be rendered to a new track. You can now drag this clip around the timeline as you need. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions about this or any other questions about Traction T7. That's pretty much it for bouncing and rendering audio tracks. Thank you so much for stopping by, and if you'd like to see more videos like this one, please subscribe to the channel. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.